Yes.
So the numbers and everything?
Yep, all the numbers are ready.
Cool, and you guys just wanna hold up outside, wouldn't it, Sam? Kevin?
Yeah.
Hey.
What's going on, drink?
No, I'm good.
Good?
I know
it's Monday.
I hope that's what I felt. Can I see what you're doing?
Making drinks, looks pretty obvious.
Man, that's fantastic.
Happy Monday.
Have you heard the phrase, speed of the leader, speed of the team?
Speed of the leader, speed of the team. No, I'm fairly new here, so never heard that phrase.
I know you're new to the management role leadership, but I think certain things you'd have to think about, kind of the example you set for the team. I would definitely say drinks is
out of the
question.
Not madman style?
No, we're not in the TV land of the 60s, so we're...
Very good then.
That's good. And the dress code too, just be mindful too of how your appearance and dress kind of plays a role.
Shorts, sure.
It looks comfortable. It's on weekends, but I love it. Thank you. But not in the work environment, so I know you're new, but...
Understandable.
Just be mindful of the example you set and how it plays out for the rest of the team. So
Thank you.
I'll buy you some time and I'll let you kind of clean that up and...
Will do.
Try to salvage that. So,
get it out of here.
Yeah, just be mindful of how your actions affect the team in the future. So,
very good.
Any questions?
I'm good. Thanks, Steven.
Thank you.
Oh man, that's awesome. Look at that. Alright guys, it's Friday. I think I'll take the project and work on it from home this weekend. It's not due for another 2 weeks, so it should be plenty of time to get ahead of the game. I'm going to head out and have happy hour. Maybe I'll see you guys there?
Alright. Go do whatever you feel you got to. I think we're probably going to stay a couple more hours. I'm going to start working on some end of year reviews.
It's only May.
Is it? I haven't slept since Christmas. I've been putting in like 100-hour work weeks. I'm going to do some 15, 16 FAFSA updates.
What do you think? You want to go grab a drink?
I have both bird and swine flu for the last month.
No offense or anything, but shouldn't you be at home, not even at work right now? How bad you look?
These direct loans aren't going to pay themselves. Plus, I've had perfect attendance for 5 years. I can't break that streak.
Oh, I'm jealous. I only got 4 years working right now.
I think you guys need a vacation.
Vacation? What's that?
I think he means lunch break.
Lunch? I can't even hold anything down.
It's really important to get the job done, but work-life balance is even more important. You want to come to work and make sure that your team is fresh and invigorated every day that you're here.
Dude, we're talking about perfect attendance. I hear this year, they're passing out certificates. Can't wait to hang that bad boy up in my cube.
I'm out of here. Have a good weekend.
Yeah, you
Bye.
Too. Is there something wrong with my shirt?
You didn't file your taxes correctly, so if you had filed your taxes correctly, this wouldn't be an issue. I mean, besides, I don't know that much about taxes and the IRS. I work for Student Aid Solutions, not a CPA firm. Have you gone to a tax filer? I bet they could probably help you out.
Not yet.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think you can help me out with this 1040X form?
Well, I think the 1040X is something about making an update to your taxes. Again, like I said, if you'd done it taxes correctly the first time, it would have been fine. But anyway, or something like that. So, listen, I got an idea. What you could do is just keep making updates to the 1040X, keep sending it in. We'll see what gets accepted. Besides, it's worth a try. And Besides, tax law is very complicated. We can make a game out of this.
Oh, but I thought I filled out my taxes correctly the first time.
Yeah, you thought wrong. But let's try the game idea out. That's a little bit easier on my side, and it sounds like a lot of fun.
Oh, okay. Thank you, then.
Oh, no problem. Anytime. Bye. Hello, this is Student Aid Solutions. How may I help you?
Hello. I was given a form that I need to fill out that's called the Loan Option Form, and I was hoping you could help me out. Do you know why I'm getting this, and if it means that I'm getting less stipend?
Sure. So we can offer you some assistance here. So actually, the form you had before you was actually a form that we try to provide to all of our students. We like to think of it as a service. With the student loan debt rising and the future burden it can put upon you down the road, think of it more as an educational tool before you take out the loans. Hopefully, as you read through the document, it helps you think more about how much aid you actually need before you start taking out some loans.
So does this mean I'm going to get less financial aid and less stipend?
Actually, the subsidized and unsubsidized loans, the loan portions of it, it's not considered gift or grant aid. That means that though they fall under Title IV, down the road you will actually have to pay them back, and we will actually have to pay them back with interest. For example, if you take out $9,500 in loans, which is the independent freshman level loan eligibility, let's say you'd have to pay these back over a 10-year period, the interest you pay back could be close to $3,600. So the $9,500 loan you take out today could end up costing you over $13,000 as a total cost for the loan. So just kind of something to think about as you turn how much in loans you actually wish to take out. So this is not necessarily affecting your eligibility. It just kind of provides some additional insight about to help you determine how much in the loans you actually need before you take it out. So does that help?
It does, actually. I never really thought about having to pay the money back with interest. Thank you very much.
Oh, you're welcome. No problem. If you have any other further questions or need other assistance, feel free to let me know. My direct extension is 555-867-5309.
Okay.
All right. Thank you. All right. Have a good day.
Bye.
I know we had our one-on-one right now. A couple quick things. You had a poor month. You didn't hit your phone metrics. You didn't hit your QA accuracy score. I mean, this month has been really poor. I got to run out to another quick meeting. I know we're set to meet, but here's the scorecard.
One question.
We'll talk soon, and we'll catch up a little bit later. Great. Thanks so much. We received many poor findings this year from the auditors regarding overlapping loans. So we really want to concentrate this year on getting better and making sure that we have a successful audit next year. Anybody got any good ideas?
Just a stronger focus on compliance. Just following up in trainings, just to make sure that e-cards are being submitted and reviewed, and just following up our teams individually on a monthly basis, maybe even do an audit before the audit, review files for any potential findings. What do you think?
I like those ideas. I mean, another day what we could do is group individuals. We think group individuals together to kind of work together a little bit more. So
that sounds great. Let's start to write up this plan so we have something formulated for this full year and really hit it home for next year. Cool. Thanks, everybody.
Awesome. Thank you.
Your accounts and check your notes, see what's going on here. So it looks like you're selected for something called verification. I think you have to do your taxes or something for that. Do you know if you've done your taxes? Personally, I've never done my taxes either, so I'm not quite sure how that really works. But I think we should be able to process a stipend still without having you verified. That shouldn't be a problem at all. How much money do you want? As much as we can give? Well, I see you're set up for about $12,000 in aid, so I can maybe I can increase that to like $25,000. Let me see what I can do. There's a note here, something called Nisildis limits. It says you're at Nisildis limits, but I think I can override this. So I think processing a stipend shouldn't be a problem. So, all right. You have any other questions for me? I can get that sent to you in a check today, if that works for you. That, you don't have to worry about you failing your classes or anything like that. That's a totally separate function. I completely understand. All right. Well, if you have no other questions, then I will end this call. Thank you very much.
Anthony, the next thing on the scorecard would be your observation percentage. So last month, your observation percentage was 61%. Do you remember me observing you? I think the call was something like student needed, wanted some stipends or something like that. Anyway, I'm pretty sure you gave the wrong time frame. You didn't really seem confident. Make sure you do better next time, all right?
So it was last month?
Yeah, it would have been last month. I mean, this is this last month's scorecard, so it had to have been last month. Okay. You remember that call you took?
About a stipend.
Yeah, it was about a stipend and verification, I think. It was a combination of verification and stipend.
So it was a student that had a verification mm-hmm. issue that needed a stipend.
Right. And there was maybe an ag limit issue, too. I don't really remember too much of the detail. But yeah, it was a stipend call. You probably only got like one or two of those last month. Yeah. And then they also wanted verification.
I don't come across, too many verification or stipend. Okay. So.
Well, next time those come up, since they're so far and few between, you should probably do better and stuff. Because 61's pretty bad.
Is there anything specific that I could work on?
I mean, just know the ins and outs about those processes and you're fine.
Okay, maybe additional training or something?
Yeah, and then you want to explain it really well, too.
Okay.
I can submit something through that star thing to request a trainer come in and maybe talk to you about it. They got that system set up, so yeah, we'll get that going. I'll have Tom Cashin come by and set that up for you.
Okay. That's definitely something I guess I can work on. I'll just make a note that the next time I get a stipend request, like I said, they don't come off too often. So
awesome. Appreciate it.
Awesome.
All right, guys, I want to thank you for coming to the meeting here so quick after the start closed. I wanted to hit some highlights and a few things that we came a little short on that we need to improve on in the future. First and foremost, the 93.7% CP was amazing, the best we've done so far this year. I want to thank you personally. You took the most tree calls for this start cycle. Kevin, I want to thank you for stepping up and helping on Ellie's list since she was on the phone so much.
Absolutely.
Really need to get through her students, her contacts, her packages, and stuff like that. So you really came through for the team there. Steven and Anthony, I really want to thank you guys for coming in and volunteering on the weekend so we could close the start out so strong. One of the things that we need to improve on next time around, it did get busy on Wednesday and Thursday. Our answer speeds were over 2 minutes. So it's kind of a disservice to our students to make them wait so long. Sometimes they're a little impatient, dropped a few more calls than we did at other points during the week. So we need to make sure that we taking that into account, the busy times during start week, and make sure that we improve that next time around. Of course, as usual, when we go through our monthly one-on-ones, I'll sit down with each of you and hit some more personal highlights and things that we need to improve on for the next time around. But overall, can't complain with the 93.7% CP. You guys did a great job this start.
Hey
guys.
Hey, what's up?
What time are you guys heading out to the charity event?
A little bit.
Hey.
Is it mandatory for us to go?
It is mandatory since it's expected for us leaders to go to this charity event.
Expected but not required.
They're not taking attendance, so
correct.
Do
Touche.
They won't know if we're not there.
They probably wouldn't, but still would be expected for us leaders to go.
My team's not going to care. I mean, what are you doing after work?
I've got a knife full of bad decisions.
Nice. I think I gotta like pick up my dry cleaning or something by 6, so.
Okay.
Oh, we're gonna head over there.
Yeah. Have fun. Let us know how it went.
Here we go.
Yeah.
Hi! Welcome!
Hi. I'm here for my money. I filled out a post withdrawal thing.
Disbursement? Yes.
Yeah, you got it. Where is it at?
Oh, okay. Let me check into the system and kind of. What was your last name again?
Jones.
Okay, Jones. Okay. All right. Oh, I see that. Yes, you did approve it,
mm-hmm.
And it's going to be about 10 business days or so for it to get here.
That was Mike Jones, right?
I'm sorry?
Mike Jones?
Yes.
Okay, about 10 business days?
Yeah, about 10 business days. And after the disbursement post and pays off the balance on your account, I noticed
mm-hmm.
that you're going to have a credit balance, which means that you're entitled for some funds back, which is not free money. It's just a credit balance left over. Yes, that is correct. And with this, I actually encourage you to consolidate the loans to help pay back all the loans that you borrowed. You just want to make sure that the importance of repaying back your loans, and here are a couple of guides that will help you determine, like, you know, what the important is and what where you have to call to get this information and how to consolidate. So here's another frequent asked questions about consolidation loans. So I highly encourage you to take a look at these.
Mm-hmm.
It is very important that you pay back your loans sooner than later, because the longer you wait to repay them back, you're going to pay back your loans in a larger amount. Yeah, so when the funds get here, we're going to mail them out, and you should get them after that. You can either come in,
mm-hmm.
or we can mail them to your home. Which one would you prefer?
So what if I don't want that? I just want to pay it back with interest. Can I do that?
Not pay back?
Yeah, or no, not get it. Just cancel it out so I don't get a credit balance and have to pay interest.
You can.
Okay.
The stipend, you can do that. We can just use whatever you have left so you can pay off your balance here, or you can set up a payment plan. So you have a couple of options there, but you still have some loans that
mm-hmm.
you borrow, so you can pay back your tuition, and it's still, we encourage you to consolidate them so you can get a potentially a lower interest rate and have all of them at the same time. You don't have to pay back 10 different loans, you just pay back one.
I like one better than 15.
Right.
Much better.
All right, well, again, my name is Ellie, so if you have any questions at all, here is my card
nice.
With my information, and feel free to give me a call or email me anytime you want.
Thank you.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Bye now.
Bye.